A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd March, on the front page you have Abhinandan arrives to hero's welcome. So this is regarding Indian Air Force fighter pilot wing commander Abhinandan Vardhman. He was arrested by Pakistani authorities when his fighter MiG-21 fighter, it was brought down and it came down in Pakistan occupied Kashmir. So he was arrested, but then we saw yesterday in news how Prime Minister Imran Khan said that as a peace gesture, he would be released by the Pakistani authorities. So he's arrived and he's, you know, at Wagha border along with Foreign Office Director of Pakistan. So crowds throng Wagha border post and pilot was whisked away by IF authorities after Pakistan handed him over. Then this is at OIC meet, India flays terror funding. So this is regarding Organization of Islamic Cooperation. So these are a group of countries which wish to be a voice of Muslim world, so Muslim countries. So at this grouping, India is not a member, but it is for the first time that India has been invited at its meeting. So the Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj, she was there at the meeting. We saw a little few days earlier how all nations had come in support of India for its action against terrorist camps in Balakot in Pakistan. But OIC, that is Organization of Islamic Cooperation, it condemned the move. So here at this meet too, Sushma Swaraj, she spoke about dismantling terror camps. So this was the 46th session of OIC, Council of Foreign Ministers, External Affairs Ministers. Then next is, on page 6, you have, fires are a crucial component of some forest systems, say group of scientists. So this is regarding the forest fire. We have seen recently how the Bandipur forest fire has engulfed almost the entire a huge amount of the region, plus also the Mudumlai Tiger Reserve in the adjoining area was also affected by forest fire. So this is an article talking about complexities of forest fires and how they need to be understood and managed better. So this is important in the context of the disaster which has struck recently. Below you have Penkuttu to take up right to sit campaign in Kerala. So this is an organization of women working as such in commercial hub of Kerala, Kozhikode. Here they are, and it is seen that women workers, especially in textile sector, they are not made to allowed to sit during their working hours. So this organization started this right to sit campaign, and now they are going to ensure that this is put into effect, that women workers are allowed to sit. So this is in context of labor welfare. And this is drought situation grim in Karnataka. So it is said 156 of 176 talukas of Karnataka reeling under severe water crisis due to deficient rainfall. Then on page 7 you have order on surveillance meant to protect privacy. Government tells Supreme Court. So this is regarding the government's order on December 20. So in this it had said that the authorities, certain authorities would have power to intercept, monitor, or decrypt any information through any computer resource. So it said this is the power derived under the note, the order is coming under section 69 of Information Technology Act 2000. So the act already provides these powers to the government and they are now being used. So it's now this case is before the Supreme Court, and in the Supreme Court the government is arguing that this is done to protect privacy. It says only authorized entities would be having the power to intercept in data. So this case is going before the Supreme Court. Arguments are being heard. Below you have more LHB coaches to be made this year. So this is regarding Link Hoffman Bosch coaches. So there are 1,422 Link Hoffman Bosch coaches which are proposed to be manufactured in 2018-19. So this Link Hoffman Bosch coaches are better than the Integral Coach Factory coaches. So that is why we propose to replace all the coaches with Link Hoffman. And you should know the comparison between the two, because we have seen many real incidents which have taken place over the last few years. Some of them have been blamed to be sabotage too. that somebody intentionally caused these rail accidents. But then the coaches which we have are such that the casualties and the as such of the incident would increase. So to reduce the disaster level and to ensure that the casualties are to the minimum, because there are these anti-collision systems which are there in Linghoffman-Bosch coaches. So you should know about the comparison of these two. Then next is Assam to be oil exporting hub for Southeast Asia. So there are many projects in Assam which are nearing completion, and Assam may soon become one of India's major oil exporting hub to the eastern neighbors of the country. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the Akali factor. So this is the political development as such. You know, BJP is in alliance in Punjab with Akali Dal. So BJP admits that the need to take a back seat in some states. So this is regarding that. And the second editorial, Hanoi Hiccup. This is regarding the Hanoi summit between US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, which clearly is a setback to attempts to find a peaceful solution to Korean nuclear crisis. They did not come up with any fruitful results after the talks. So it is, the editorial says that despite the collapse of talks, US and North Korea must persist with confidence building measures. The lead article, ensure a minimum income for all. So this is regarding the basic income scheme. It has been in news quite often. So this article also talks of how it will deliver benefits to the poor only if it comes on top of public services. So it's a huge amount of expenditure under basic income scheme, because the minimum income has to be provided to a huge section of the population. So what may happen is the public services which are provided presently may be deprived, they may be ending free services. And then like we have various schemes in place for various aspects, like for food, for health. So if income has been provided, then if these services are taken away, then it would be a huge problem. So that is why this article says basic income should be on top of public services. Then this is mixed signals from Pakistan. So this is regarding Pakistani military's thinking and the politician statements and actions, how they think and analyze the army and how the politicians give statements and actions that they take. So there are mixed signals, is clear. On Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage. So it's a detailed coverage on one issue, and today it is about changing the stripes of conservation. So this is regarding the man-eating tigress Avni, how it was killed in Maharashtra's Yavatmal district because of rising man-animal conflict. So this and other such incidents have taken place. So how development projects in tiger habitats and fragmentation of migration corridors call for a rethink of conservation policy is being discussed here. Then on page 10, you have this news, but this is completely political, about alliance between AAP and Congress. There are speculations. And this is quota ordinance will benefit 36 lakh in J&K, says Centre. So this is regarding the ordinance which has been promulgated, regarding the cabinet has approved it, Jammu and Kashmir Reservation Amendment Ordinance. So it says it is to help border residents and those from weaker sections. On page 11, you have MP's panel raises questions on Balakot. So members ask Foreign Secretary to scotch misinformation campaign and speculation. So there have been speculations of war, and there have been misinformations which are being put forth in out. So these need to be clarified. So that is what the Standing Committee on External Affairs of the Parliament is asking the Foreign Secretary for. Then there is no important news on the international page. It's continuation of previous news items only. Yesterday's news continued too. And on business page, you have SEBI slashes regulatory fee for brokers. So there is 33.33% reduction in charges on intermediaries. So this is said to bring down overall trading costs for investors. And GST collection drops to 97,247 crores in February. Giant figures had crossed 1 lakh crore mark. And this is regarding manufacturing PMI, Purchasing Managers Index. So this is a private sector survey. So Manufacturing PMI is at a 14-month high of 54.3 in February. Then there's more important news on the last page too. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com in the current affairs section. And here you can download the current affairs PDFs too. The monthly compilations will also be available in a day or two. And also you can avail for a detailed current affairs course, details of which are provided here. So that is it. Thank you.